Welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Marie. If you're new here, welcome. I'm so happy to see you guys once again. I just wanted to get on here just to kind of talk to you guys a little bit, share just something that was on my heart. Do you guys ever go through like seasons in your life where you feel like God has told you to do something, right? Like you feel like this season God is telling me to maybe write a book. God is telling me to maybe travel and go, you know, somewhere to do missions or ministry or something. Not even ministry related. It can be anything. You feel like God, you know, you feel in your spirit that God is telling you like this season, this is what you're supposed to be doing. You know, you get all hyped up, all faith hyped, you know, built up in the word, encouraged, and just ready to go, right? And you take like the first one or two steps and then something happens, like something totally unexpected happens. Something that, you know, it could be good or bad, like it's something good or bad, but it totally unexpected just comes to kind of change your plans, right? Because if you're anything like me, when God speaks to you or the Lord starts to put something on your heart, like you get excited, you have like an image or a vision of what the thing, how it's gonna go, you know. For example, when the Lord laid on my heart to start this YouTube channel, you know, in my mind, okay, YouTube, a lot of people are gonna start following you, and then, you know, your ministry is gonna go global. Like, that's my mind. So like I think straight, just like go with whatever idea the Lord gives me. So I don't think about like the pitfalls or turns or anything like that. So when he gives it to me, for me, it's about to be just great, or it's just about to be like a straight shot. And then something unexpected happens, like whether good or bad, something unexpected happens, right? So you don't know what to do, okay? Because you feel like what is happening right now is contrary to what the Lord has told you, and you don't really know how to move forward. You start wondering, like, God, like, you know, did I really hear from you? Because things are not going the way you thought it was gonna go, right? So you begin to doubt. You begin to, if you're anything like me, you start just panicking, because that's me. Then I start panicking. And then in comes doubt, like, God, did you really talk to me? Was I imagining these things? Did I make this stuff up? You know, is the enemy deceiving me to get me off the track that you have set me on? And just these type of thoughts, like, that's the type of thoughts I have to fight against when these things happen. So if you're like that, and you're just going through a season where you feel like, okay, God, you told me that this is what's going to be happening in the season that I'm in, or this is the vision you gave me for the season that I'm in, but things are not going as planned, things are not going as imagined, I just want to let you know that nothing that happens in your life is a surprise to God, right? God may not have given you the details. The Bible says, like, we see in part, and we only see in part, right? Where we are in life right now, God doesn't always show us the full picture of things. Sometimes if he did show us the full picture, we would just run from it, like, we would just run. So sometimes he only shows us only a part of it, like a part of the vision, right? So we tend to like come up with the rest. We tend to imagine it the way we want it to go, but nothing that happens afterwards is a surprise to God. The Lord knew like the changes that were going to happen. He knew like the good things, the surprises, the twists, the turns, the falls. He knew all of that was going to happen, all right? So if the Lord gave you a word, the Lord told you like this is the season that you're in, and then something totally unexpected has happened. Somebody may have passed away in your family. He told you to travel, and then, you know, you started saving up and you lose your job, or something even good, you know, you're thinking about how to plan your ministry, and, you know, if you're a woman or a man, you know, doing things on your own, being able to travel on your own time, do whatever you want. And then maybe your boyfriend, or if your boyfriend proposes, and, you know, now you got to plan a wedding, but then you don't know how to balance, you know, planning a wedding, planning for a new family, and doing what you thought the Lord was telling you to do. All of that can be discouraging, and I just don't let the enemy discourage you with that, okay? The Lord saw all of that coming when he gave you that mission. If the Lord gave you that mission, he will walk you through it. The Holy Spirit that is in you is not moved by whatever is happening around you. He's not moved by the change in circumstance. What is a surprise to you is not a surprise to him, okay? You are supposed to depend on the Holy Spirit in you to lead you to accomplish whatever the Lord has led you, I told you to do. So don't worry. Just relax, okay? Relax, pick up your Bible, get encouraged and filled up in the word, and submit, surrender everything, whatever the project is, whatever the vision was, whatever has come up, the circumstance that's arose without you expecting it. Commit it all to the Holy Spirit and let Him lead you day by day. That is the big, 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 big tip. Day by day. Do not think so far ahead that you start just freaking out, okay? Day by day. When you wake up, you pray, Holy Spirit, thank you for this day and help me to do what you need me to do today. Some days it may not be a big project that the Lord needs you to do. It may not be a big thing that He needs you to do towards that bigger project. Sometimes it's just waking up, being obedient to take care of your family, being obedient to take care of yourself and keeping yourself healthy. That could be it for the day. So you just be sensitive to the Holy Spirit. Let Him lead you in the project that He gave you, in the vision that He gave you, and stay within His timing. You do not need to panic. You don't need to freak out, okay? God is with you. God knew what was going to happen before He talked to you, and He knew that He will be able to get you through it. If that wasn't the case, if it was not Him, to get you through it, okay? So I just want to encourage you today, if that's you, just relax. Brother, relax. Sister, just breathe. The Lord's got you, okay? I love you so much, and I'm just going to pray a quick prayer for you just to encourage you, and then I'll be out of here, okay? Just a real quick word. Heavenly Father, I just want to thank you for the lives of your beautiful people, your precious people that you love with all your heart. Lord Jesus, I pray that the person watching this right now that may be a little discombobulated, that may be a little confused, that may has started doubting your word, started doubting your voice, Lord, I pray that you will just reinforce your strength, you will reinforce your word, that you will empower them from within, and just reminding them, Lord, that it was you who spoke to them. And I pray that you will teach them to depend on the Holy Spirit for the vision, for the ministry, for the project that you have given them. Help them to know, Lord Jesus, that it was you were not surprised by the circumstance that is around them, by the change in events in their lives, Lord. Lead them according to your purpose and let your glory be made manifest, Lord, throughout it all, and do it in a way that only you, Father, only you receive the glory. We love you, Lord Jesus, and we bless your mighty name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you, brothers and sisters. I'll see you guys next time. And again, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share these videos just so somebody else can be encouraged, okay? Love you. Bye.